going on, guys? This is Bruce Mattson, your host of the show, Metric Scout Fantasy Football, the show that looks at fantasy football from a deeper perspective. We talk about redraft, dynasty, DFS, Devy, all of it, and everything in between. Something you're interested in, hit that subscribe button. Ring the bell, tell your homies. This time last year, Clyde Edwards-Helaire's dynasty and redraft value was shot out of a cannon. He went from like the RB25-ish, whatever it was, in ADP, and shot up to the top five overall player in Dynasty. Then the season unfolded, and now he's sitting around an ADP of around 25, which is a major drop compared to where he was at. What I think that is creating a potential buying opportunity for some of us dynasty leaguers, and even in redraft, because he's falling in the late second round, according to Underdog Fantasy ADP. This is more of his appropriate value, where he should be valued at. This is probably where he should have been valued at from the beginning. The reason why his price fell so much is because the expectations was way too high. If you look back to other analysts, other fantasy football analysts, they're pegging him to catch like 60, 70, 80, even 100 passes last year. Every analyst that you have projecting that out, you really got to think where their process was at for that. You had another subset that was more towards Jonathan Taylor, Cam Akers, DeAndre Swift, the other running backs in the draft, saying the trade back in rookie drafts, saying to go after those running backs instead, me included. I'm a Jonathan Taylor guy, but I don't hate Clyde Edwards-Helaire. I thought he was overvalued from the get-go. I knew that jump in value created a bubble in his price tag, and I knew it was going to pop, and it did. The air let out during the season, and now he's valued at RB15 in Dynasty, top 25 pick overall when he used to be an overall 5 guy, and a late second round pick in redraft. I mean, it doesn't make any sense. He's a rookie and he played well. He had 4 RB1 weeks, 4 RB2 weeks, and only 3 weeks where he was outside the top 30 at his position. So he's very reliable and he had some upside. He accounted for 1,100 yards from scrimmage. 803 of that was from rushing. 297 was from receiving, which is very good, very productive. Any other rookie that does that and their stock is going to the moon. Clyde Edwards-Helaire though, since the expectations was set so high from the beginning, from the jump, he had to take a step back. That was not fair to him. That was not fair to his dynasty stock. And now we see him as more like an iffy running back when you look at him towards value. But really, his situation hasn't really changed. If not, it's gotten better. The depth chart at the running back position for the Chiefs, they didn't really add anything. The only thing they've added to maybe impact him, which probably won't, was Jared McKinnon. Outside of that, they still got Darren Williams, they still got Darren Thompson, still got Elijah McGuire. They still have those Jags. And I get it, they took him off the field for short yardage, goal line situations, didn't get as much passing work as what we were expecting. But he was still fifth on the team on targets with 55. Still decent receiving production. Almost hit 300 yards receiving. And he's just growing into the offense. He's a rookie. He was a rookie last year. You got to expect rookies to start off slower than expected. You got to be patient with rookies. He still averaged 2.98 yards after contact per attempt. 540 yards after contact on the entire year. He had 21 carries of 10 plus yards, 8 carries of 15 plus yards, so he can stretch it downfield. You saw him have some big runs last year. He had a lot of highlight plays. He forced 31 missed tackles, 14th most in the league. That's tied with James Robinson, rookie darling from last year, and Kareem Hunt. The team made some changes to the offensive line. They have Orlando Brown now. They drafted a center in the second round. It looks like they're moving some pieces to make the offensive line better. Hopefully the rushing attack will be better as well. A great impact for that and allow him to be more efficient. He's going to be used in the passing game. Again, last year was COVID. that impacted the rookies. Some of the rookies you couldn't tell because they played well, and some you couldn't tell because they're rookies. They start off slower than usual. He's now going to have a full offseason. He did not have that last year. So this is going to allow him to transition more into the offense, get more comfortable with the play calling, get more comfortable with the scripts for blocking. Everything's going to come together a little more, and the price is right now. You're talking 25 overall player in Dynasty. You're talking about a running back who was drafted in the first round to a generational offense. This is offense for the Chiefs is so explosive that this is a generational offense. You don't get an offense like this every year. You're talking about a generational offense that drafted Clyde Edwards-Helaire in the first round. We don't get many of these offenses ever. Really, throughout my lifetime, we've had a few explosive offenses that lasted for quite a while as a dynasty. And the Chiefs is like this. Once this era of the Chiefs is done, this offensive firepower juggernaut led by Mahomes, it's going to go down in history books. People are not going to forget about this offense for a long time. Clyde Edwards-Helaire is a part of it. And I get it. Clyde Edwards-Helaire is not the most talented running back from a physical perspective. I get it. I beat that drum till holes burst through it last year. But the price is right now. It's not the 101 anymore. He's not the 105. He's not being overdrafted. I want to draft him now. I don't hate his game. I think he's a good player. I like him at the right value. I like him at this value. I like how he can catch the ball in the backfield. He has that floor in PBR. I think he can improve what he did from last season. He's not bad at running the ball. He sees the field well. He has good micro movements, the breakdown, defenders in the open field to create extra yardage. There's a lot of good things he does in his game. And for him to slip and be a part of this mega offense is a big travesty. We have some running backs, some wide receivers. We have some red flags in front of them, like Devonta Adams. We don't even know if Aaron Rodgers is going to be there. And if Aaron Rodgers is gone and we're drafting Devonta Adams ahead of Clyde Edwards-Helaire, then that's going to be a big problem. Because Clyde Edwards-Helaire is not going to lose Mahomes. Clyde Edwards-Helaire is going to be a focal point in the offense because they're going to need him to run the football. They're going to need him to catch passes out of the backfield. And they're going to expand what he can do in the offense. The longer he's in the offense, the more they're going to allow him to do. It's not like he's going to get worse. If anything, he's going to get better. He's going to get more acclimated. And going into this season, I think we're going to see him used more. I think he's going to put up RB1 numbers. He can be back in RB1, mid-tier RB1. But if it's better than last year, then it's going to be good for us either way. He gave us 8 fantasy-relevant weeks. 4 of them were RB1 weeks. That's solid for a rookie. Any other rookie that does that, we're jumping off the bit to get him. But Clyde Edwards-Helaire slides down. You don't hear anybody talking about him. No one's pumping him up. The guy last year, me, who was telling everyone to calm down, don't overpay for him, is now on his side. That says something. It means I'm objective and I'm looking at this guy. I think he's good. I think he's good enough to be drafted at this ADP. I think he should be worth a little more, especially since he's a running back. Running backs, after you get past the third round, past the middle part of the third round or wherever that's at, that sticking point, the drop-off's huge. I'm talking on Clyde Edwards-Helaire could be your third running back and be a good fit for your team. Imagine rolling him out as your flex. You didn't dream of that last year because you were drafting him as your RB1. Now you can draft him as your RB3 and be happy about it. Him catching passes from Mahomes in the flat and an offense that's always going to be moving. And him getting more snaps, more targets, more workload is what we should be projecting from him for this year. There's no way that he does not get more usage, more run, more carries, and see bigger running lanes because of it. I think Clyde Edwards-Helaire is a hell of a buy at this price tag. I think everyone needs to be looking at him for redraft, especially redraft. I think his price is going to go up in redraft once we get into August. People start realizing how stiff this pool of running backs is and how much value they should be putting in Helaire versus the wide receivers. And then, two, people are going to start talking about the offensive line, start talking about the Chiefs' offense about Clyde Edwards-Helaire's ability, and they're going to pump him up a little bit. He might be pushed an early second round. I think some of the prospects in the early part of the second round, mid-second round, they're probably going to drop a little bit, and there's going to be some ebbs and flows. That's just natural. Dynasty, I think he's going to go up a little bit too between now and the start of the season because he's got a lot of utility for fantasy rosters, and that holds value. Right now we're in the offseason. People are just trying to make the roster sexy, but when it comes down to setting those lineups, a guy like Clyde Edwards-Helaire is going to do a lot for you. And that's what I want on my teams, especially at this price tag. This is the right price to get Clyde Edwards-Helaire, and this is probably the time to snatch him up because if he does what we were hoping he would do last year, or even 80, 90% of that, especially in the passing game. If he catches 50 balls, which is possible, 55, then his price tag in Dynasty is going to move up immensely. It's going to move up. He'll be a top 5 back, top 6, 7, 8, whatever. It's going to be a top 10 guy easy, and you need to buy him at this price. And if not, you know you got a running back that's going to give you utility. They're not going to move away from him without giving him all the chances in the world. They spent that draft capital. They're going to allow that sunk cost to their crew. And they do like him. They tried whatever they could last year to get him on the field and keep him on the field and use him. They showed that. And they want to use him. They want to get him more acclimated. I think he's a safe investment as well. I think this price point is perfect for him. The only way this gets better is if he gets hurt during the season and his price drops. You don't wish that on players. That's a shitty thing to do. But this is a good price for Clyde Edwards-Helaire. That's all I'm trying to talk about. Snatch him up now while you can. This offseason, it's only going to get better, or it'll at least be a key piece to your dynasty or redraft team. Thank you for sticking with me this long while ranting about football. I must have kept you entertained, so you might as well hit that subscribe button, ring the bell, tell your homies, get the word out about this show, let everyone know, shoot me some comments, help the algorithm, and I'll catch you next time.